agree on, right? My brother-in-law? He should be back any minute. Hello, everyone! What did the Oracle say? The Oracle. It's a thing that... Never mind. You're too stupid to understand.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
Shouldn't I say this to you in private?
What say the people?
No!
I've got nothing to hide. Let's have it.
Very well. I have spoke to the god Apollo. Who spoke through the oracle and said that the city is besieged by this plague.
Well, no shit, besieged by the plague, you asshat!
Hey, shut up! Shut up! Let it finish.
Totally more of that sentence. Spoke to Paula, who spoke through the oracle, who said the city is besieged by this plague because the killer of our former king, Laius, it's yet unpunished and actually resides here in this city.
Wait! The who's it and the what's it? What are you talking about?
Oh, that's right. See, Oedipus, before you became king, we had this other king.
Wait! I remember. I came into town and you people made me king because I was the only one who could solve the riddle of the Sphinx. I remember. Remember that time? Remember that time? Back in time! Back in time! Oh my god! You're adorable! You're so fucking adorable! What's your name?
My name is Oedipus.
You wanna get high?
I have more important matters to which I must attend.
Oh my god! You're so adorable! You're so fucking adorable! Turn out for you. You ready to play the game, honey?
I'm here to solve the riddle, if that's what you mean.
You are so fucking cute! Oh my god! Jesus, you're just fucking cute.
Okay, here we go. What manner of creature walks on four legs, then on two legs, then on three legs?
Man.
Chupacabra.
Speaks! Where'd you go? Hey! Speaks! Speaks!
Speaks!
Speaks! Speaks! Yes! So that's how I said. Remember that? Remember how awesome I was?
Anyway, our former king, Laius, who's married to your current wife, Joe Posnovich, must be pretty weird for you. Was murdered down at the old swimming hole.
Is that right?
Yes, and the murderer was never caught.
Wow, that's terrible. But you guys got the guys who did it, right? I mean, you went after him. You cut the a-holes and killed your king and beat the hell out of him, right?
Well, not really.
He was all freaked out by this thing.
You know, I find it really shameful that you people didn't do anything. But I'm not like you people. I'm the kind of guy who likes to make things happen. Yeah. I just write down that sphinx and I solve this riddle. And now, I'm going to track down the old king's killer. Watch and learn. Hey! Is there anyone here who can tell me who killed King Laius?
Hey, man, keep it down, man. We're right here.
There's someone here who can tell us who killed the old king! There might be a reward!
You ought to ask that old blind prophet that always hangs out by the men friend.
Why, here he comes now! Oh, that's over there!
He knows everything!
therefore my other senses are enhanced. Also, I can fly. So, I heard you call my name, and here I am.
Hey, townspeople, see how easy that is? I'm already cracking the case and I just found out about it. Now why don't you losers go stand in the shadows and watch? I don't want to get any idiot terms from you. Go. We sent Creon here to visit the Oracle and find out what's causing this plague. He said that it's because the killer of Laius, who was king here before me, is still alive here in the city and never got punished.
Yeah, but that was a really long time ago. I'm sure whoever did that is suffering from some really bad karma right now. No sense chasing after the past.
Hey, tell that to the Sphinx! Wait, no, the other one, the Oracle!
Yeah,
that's what it said! The killer of Laius is yet unpunished, and that's why we've got this play!
We want you to help us find the king's killer!
What did he just say?
I know, but gee whiz, fellas! Let bygones be bygones! It's not healthy to hold a grudge.
Look, I'm not all that interested in avenging the king's death. Things have worked out pretty well for me here.
Yeah.
But I'm the king here now, and my people are suffering. My people!
Don't you understand me?
I'm responsible for these people!
Yeah, but you're probably just freaking out because you're not used to the plague. Once you've had the plague for about a year or so, you'll be used to it. You'll probably be friends with the plague. You'll probably finger it.
You seem to know a lot about this plague.
Yes.
Maybe a little too much.
No.
You are probably the one who's causing it, aren't you?
No.
You killed Laius.
No,
did you hear that? He killed King Laius, everyone. Did you hear that? The stinky old blind prophet probably killed Laius.
Look at him. He's old and stinky and blind and stinky. And even if he did kill King Laius, that's going to make King Laius look pretty bad. That's going to make the whole town look pretty bad.
Oh, hey, aren't you from that town without that king that got killed by that blind guy?
Is what they will say.
I think you're stinky.
You don't know from stinky.
I see. You're in on too much. The two of you, you sons of bitches, you probably planned this whole thing and now you're trying to cover it up, but you're too stupid to do it, aren't you? I always heard that blind people are stupid. I guess they were right.
You just went there, you asshole. I was trying to be noble by preventing you from going on this quest. Okay, you want the truth? I'll give you the truth, King Oedipus the King. The truth is, you killed Laius.
What?
That's right, King Oedipus the King. King Poopy Pants. You killed Laius, the former king.
Sorry, son of a bitch, I can't believe you stooped this low. I say one little thing and you drop that on me? You hear that, everybody? This old blind idiot's trying to say that I killed King Laius.
Oh, look at me, everybody. I'm blind, so I've got superpowers.
It's a shame on your superpowers suck.
I can't believe it. That ain't nice.
Very nice.
Quiet!
The killer of Laius is both son and brother, or father and brother, something like that.
What? What does that mean? What are you saying?
I can only say that the killer of Laius is both husband and son to his wife.
Why are you talking like that? What does this mean? What are all these things you're saying? They don't really seem to pertain to what I'm asking. I hurt you so much right now.
I can say no more. I'm late for my acting class.
He's saying me!
Please enjoy a very brief interlude of traditional ancient Greek classic music and dance.
Oh my God. friend. I'm resolute in both my convictions and my fury. You must die! You're trying to overthrow me. To hell with all that now. For the next hour or so, I'm going to be doing whatever you want.
All right, go down on your wife. I'm going back here.
Sometimes it's hard.
Kingdom. Shut up!
It's okay, Oedipus. You're still a king.
That stinky old blind prophet's trying to say that I'm the one who killed your husband.
Oh, honey. Prophets are always wrong about everything. Except when they predict floods or earthquakes, because there are always floods and earthquakes.
Guess you're probably right.
Of course I'm right. Here's a perfect example. The Delphic Oracle once told Laius that he'd be killed by his own son, but that's impossible because we nailed that baby's feet together and then left it to die. Cool, right?
Doesn't tickle.
Ow! And then it was a band of thieves that killed Laius. So see, prophets are full of crap.
Where did this happen?
Well, hey, isn't it time for the races?
Oh, the crab races, the crab centipede races, the crab caterpillar race. Come on, watch. No, not the crossroads. I meant described later.
Oh. Well, Laius was kind of tall, kind of cute. He had these gigantic nuts.
This is horrible.
What? What is it? Tell me, come on. Well,
remember how when I came here, I told you that I used to be a prince over in Corinth? One night, we were at this banquet, and this drunk guy got up and started yelling out that I'm not really the son of the king and queen of Corinth. And seeing as how drunk guys are usually such reliable sources of information, I decided to check it out. And so I went to the shrine of Delphi.
Oh, I love that shrine.
Me too. The shrine didn't really tell me anything. Only that someday I would sleep with my mother and kill my father. So that's when I got the hell out of Corinth and came here.
So, what's that got to do with anything?
Well, on the day that I arrived, I was at that three-way crossroads down by the swimming pool, and this group of marauding strangers started messing with me. So I killed them! I killed them all! It was horrible!
Oh, all by yourself?
Oh. I know, right? You're pretty tough when I have to, huh? Yeah. Anyway, I'm really concerned because it happened at the same place that you said. And you said that Laius was tall and kind of cute and had gigantic nuts. So did the main guy that I killed. I'm not saying anything out loud, but it sounds like maybe I killed the previous king. Who told you how he got killed?
It was a household servant. Porky McTurd!
Porky McTurd!
How can we find him? Does he still work here?
No. So here is the thing. After he got back to town and found out you were the new king, he asked if he could live way out in the country where there are no cars or telephones. So I said, sure. And that's where he's gone. I just assumed that maybe you guys accidentally had sex once or twice when you were drunk. So maybe he was embarrassed and left town.
How can we find him?
I'll send him a note for this passenger pigeon. Go!
Yeah,
Oedipus!
Oh my god, Oedipus! This is nothing like Rex!
I'm Oedipus, what is it?
Joy! The king of Corinth has died. If you're there, would you be their king?
Awesome! Yeah, baby! Your dad died, and you didn't kill him. This is badass. Now, if he can just keep you from porking your mom, we will have beaten fate.
unless he died of grief from my leaving. But I didn't touch him, so I can't see how that would possibly count. Awesome! Now, if only my mother weren't still alive, things would be super awesome.
This is a very strange coincidence. You see, before I got this job as a messenger, I used to be a shepherd. And one day, I came upon this baby, its feet fastened together. And that baby was you. And I took you to the king and queen of Corinth.
Do you know who put me out there in that field?
Porky McTurr!
Can you find him?
No! I am so bored! Come on, Oedipus. Let's go make out.
Not now, Jocasta! Can you wait just a few seconds?
Now,
Oedipus,
I'm so serious. I want it now.
Not
now, Jocasta! You will never get any of this again if you don't come inside right this instant.
Baby, I'm the king. I can get whatever I want. She's actually being very polite. She's afraid it's going to be revealed that I come from a poor family. But never mind all that. In a few minutes, when that guy gets back, we'll all know who they are. Yay!
Excuse me, King Oedipus, for I have found the shepherd, McTurr. This is the shepherd that brought you to me when you were that fat, goofy, big bastard.
Hey! Hey! Come on! Come on.
Sorry.
So, you're Porky McTurr. Sorry, Porky, let's have it. Who are my parents? Oh, you picked a fine time to start eating. Understand that, but if you don't tell me right now, I'm going to rip your testicles off with some pliers. Tell me, who are my parents?
Okay, well, all I can say then is that you are the son of Laius and Jocasta.
And the brother.
I'm my wife's son?
What? The funny thing, Jocasta gave you to me to kill, because it had been prophesied that you would kill your father and sleep with your mother, which you did. And I feel kind of bad because instead of leaving you, I feel like you that other shepherd, so you could be raised as a prince in Corinth. But you had to go and fuck it all up. You know, I had to kill your dad and fuck your mother.
Oh,
Jason, Adam Adams.